For me, security and beauty are not compatible. When you seek beauty, you have to forget security and you have to go to the rim of catastrophe. And there you find the beauty. If a musician makes a mistake, a crack, because he risked everything to get the most beautiful thing and he failed, then I thank him for this failure, because it is only with this risk you can get the beauty, the real beauty. The real beauty is not available at all. But we're always on search. We're never there. And there is no proper interpretation of anything. The kiss of the muse is the real property. A mistake can be more inspiring than the proper thing.
You were a performer for many years, and yeah. I know you didn't get onto the podium with a major orchestra, I think, until you were in your 40s. And you're not very enamoured of the whole maestro idea, are you? You're not interested in being a maestro. Why not?
Because for me, maestro is a hairdresser. If you read the advertising of a concert, if you read the old advertising, the composer is in an important place, but not the conductor. And then from generation to generation, the composer becomes smaller and the conductor becomes bigger. And now the audience doesn't go to listen to a work, it goes to this magician on the stage. And this is a distortion of the art.
So do you see yourself first and foremost then as a conductor, or a practicing musician, or a musical historian and thinker?
No, musical historian and thinker I'm only at home. When we started with Concentus, we said we change the leadership for every program we study. And it turned out that it always fell back to me. Maybe this is my profession, to be the leader. In the earlier times, the orchestras said sometimes, they want to play with studied conductors, that you can study conducting. But the question is, what is that? What is that? To beat one of the good conductors like Klemperer said, I can tell to my, to, what is Putzfrau?
Cleaner.
Yeah? Yeah. I can teach her conducting in an hour. If there is a 5-4 meter, I need another hour. In the early times, Bach had never studied conducting. He took a paper, roll of music, so that everybody in the chorus could see him, and showed with his hands what he wanted. And I found out that this is very easy. I can do that even so-called complicated works like Bartok. If the orchestra agrees, it's easy to show what you mean. The important thing is to find out what the work will tell. And this is almost impossible to teach. Facts. There are some facts, but it is not so clear.
You expect your audience to really actively engage with listening. It's not a passive activity, is it, listening?
No, they cannot go ironing while they listen to it, because the iron would stop and the shirt would be burned.
So you do it to keep people, for health and safety reasons. It is really essential, though, I think, for you, it seems, that it's not just a question of giving out this music and expecting it to go out there and people can sit there passively. You want your audience to give something back, that the relationship between the musicians and the audience has to be a dynamic one.
Yes, yes, because music is a language. And a language needs not only listeners, but also people who answer, who react, at least react. You cannot have always answering people, but reacting is absolutely necessary.
When you come to London and you step onto the podium and you're about to perform the Missa Solemnis, what's the feeling even now as you stand on the podium? Just before you're about to start performing a piece, is there still that visceral thrill and excitement about doing this?
Yes. You're a little bit too small for the task. This is the feeling. one can call it, it is a bit of being afraid, but it is just a bit of that. And you know that you can never reach the point which you have to reach.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh.